Hello and welcome to Controllers Tech. This is yet another video on the W25Q series external flash memory, and today I will continue covering the H750 microcontroller that I covered in the previous video. In the last video we saw how to use the external flash memory on this controller, how to use the memory mapped mode, and how to create the external loader. 2 weeks ago I made a video about the LVGL on STM32, covering how to store the assets in the external flash memory. I also mentioned that we will load the entire LVGL from external flash using the XIP, execute in place. This video was supposed to be covering that, but it was getting very lengthy, and that is why I decided to cover the XIP separately. So basically in today's video we will see how to load an application from the external flash memory. There are going to be two projects in this video. The first one will be used to make the control jump to the external memory, and the second project will contain the application in the external memory. Let's start the Cube IDE, and create a new project. We will create the project from the existing IOC file. Here I am choosing the cube file of the QuadSPI project we created in the previous video. Let's rename this project to boot from external flash. Alright, our basic setup is already here, which includes the clock setup and the QuadSPI setup. We only need to reconfigure the MPU. Here we have already created a memory region for the QuadSPI with 8 MB in size. Inside this region, we will create another region of 1 MB in size, starting from the beginning of the QuadSPI memory. The MPU configuration should be the same for this region, but we will also allow instruction access to this region. That is all we need to configure in the CubeMX. Click Save to generate the project. The QuadSPI files in this project are newly generated, and hence they don't have the data from the previous project. Let's delete these files, and instead we will copy the files from the previous project. These files contain the functions needed to make the QuadSPI work. Alright, now, in the main function, initialize the QuadSPI, and enable the memory mapped mode. Now we will make the jump to the external memory. Here we are defining the function that will make the jump to the external memory. Here is the address of the QuadSPI memory, where the function will make the jump to. Let's copy the rest of the code after the memory mapped mode is enabled. Here we first disable the cache. Make sure both cache are enabled before you call the functions to disable them. If you have not enabled the cache, comment out these lines. You can enable the cache in the MPU configuration. I am enabling them as it improves the system performance by a significant amount. We can now leave these statements to disable the cache. Now disable the SysTick interrupt. Then configure the reset handler, and set the stack pointer. Finally make the jump to the address. Let's build and debug the project. I am setting a breakpoint to this statement. Let's run the debugger. Alright, we have hit the breakpoint. Let's step over this statement. Now we have reached the statement which will make the jump to the external memory. When we step over this statement, the control enters the hard fault. This is fine because there is no executable program in the external memory right now. Hence we got the hard fault here. Now we need to store an application in the external flash memory. Let's create a new project. Choose the board, give some name to the project, and click Finish. Today we will run a very simple application from our external flash, where we will just blink a LED. Here is the schematic of the board I am using, and you can see the LEDs connected to the pin PA1. Alright, we will start with the clock setup first. I am choosing the external crystal to provide the clock. The board has 25 MHz crystal on it, and I am running the system at 400 MHz. Now set the pin PA1 as the output. We will configure the MPU just like we did in another project. Enable the first region. Set the address to 90 million hex. The external flash memory is 8 megabytes in size. All access is permitted. Disable the instruction access, disable the shareability permission, and enable the cacheable and bufferable permissions. Enable another region with the same address. The region size should be 1 megabytes, and permit all the access. Enable the instruction access to this region, disable the shareable permission, and enable the cacheable and bufferable permissions. That is all we need to configure in the CubeMX. Click Save to generate the project. Open the flash script, and modify the default flash parameters. Set the start address to 90 million hex, and the length to 8 megabytes. Basically, we are setting the external flash memory as our main flash. Now open the system source file, and scroll down to the system initialization function. We need to relocate the vector table to the external flash, so first reset the configuration register to 0, and then assign the quad SPI address to the vector table offset register. That's all the configuration we need. Let's write the main function now. As I mentioned today, we will just blink the LED, so toggle the pin PA1 every 1 second inside the while loop. Let's build the project now. Since this entire project will be loaded to the external flash memory, we need the external loader to perform the operation. Here is the loader that we created in the previous video. I am copying it to the main project folder. Here it is inside the project folder. Let's create the debug configuration for this project. We will add the external loader, which we just copied into the project. The download is verified, but the control is not in the main function. Just reset the debugger here. You can see the control is in the main function now. Let's run the debugger. You can see the LED on the board is blinking every second. Our application is running fine on the external flash memory. You can even see the current execution address here. The address is located in the external flash memory. So everything is working fine. We were able to successfully run the application from the external flash memory. This was a simple test application. In the next video we will run the entire LVGL project from external flash itself. This is it for this video. I hope you understood everything explained in the video. Leave comments in case of any doubt. Keep watching, and have a nice day ahead.